years.
Wow.
Yeah. 33 years.
Well, folks, but you know what happened around 1979 or so? The music started changing. And,
oh, yeah.
Well, yeah, there were these new bands. There was one band called R.E.M. Remember that band, R.E.M.? And, you know, I was talking to Mike Mills about 6-7 years ago, just before they broke up. And I was talking about this song called Don't Go Back to Rockville. And I said, Mike, you gotta tell me this song. I want to know, like, a little tape recorder, a little, like, digital tape recorder. I said, Mike, I want to put you on here, and I want you to tell me the story, because it's about Rockville, Maryland. It's about a girlfriend that Mike Mills had at the University of Georgia in Athens, and she was from Rockville, Maryland. She was down the street. And I said, Mike, tell me the story. Is it really about your girl? It's, yes, it is. And of course, you know who produced that. Don Dix has been a great friend of ours, and back in those days, 79, 80, and 81, I used to get a new album in the mail, and back when you had liner notes, I'd turn the thing over and say, produced by Don Dix. And I said, my God, who is that guy, Don Dix? He's everywhere. Every album I see, it says, produced by Don Dixon. So Don had a lot to do with the change in music. Don has always been a great friend of ours. And then... I'm in the mail, he said, Color Me Gone. Oh, you remember that band? How many people remember Color Me Gone? That, of course, we all fell in love with Marty Jones.
Yeah.
Who is now a great painter. MartyJonesDixon.com. There you go. You'd be surprised, there's a whole other side of Marty Dixon Jones. Right. This is after your long, by the way, your hair's coming back, my long hair. Starting over again. So I'll tell you what, and I'm going to ask you a favor also, because Don and Marty are going to do some great acoustic set to take the show off, okay? So as they say in those clubs like the Birchmere, remember the Cellar Door, remember the folk clubs, that was a placard on the table saying, in consideration of the musicians, please keep it down. So that's the reason for good stuff. And really happy. I haven't seen them in a few years now, so I'm really happy that they have joined us. They will be in the documentary, by the way, which gives you even more reason to support what
we're doing.
Okay?
Okay?
So are you ready?
Yes!
We'll start it off quiet, and then we'll kind of walk out a little bit, okay? So, please give a warm, Dylan Insane welcome to Marty Jones and Don Dixon!
Riding down the pipe on a cold December day, I was here for the sky, no time to take the stage. I sang there on the weekends with some friends I knew from school. We sang songs and made a beat, acted up the fool at exactly 804. I stand, I must stand up, brushed on my suit, straight my tie. There was a woman on my left, woman on my right. I had a powerful ambition, pitching this Sunday night. I was standing at the microphone, crowd in front of me, when a man named Jerry Johnson pulled that rock and roll on me. He was standing by the door, didn't look and stop the show. The tears was in his eyes. was singing a sad song. And it only meant that Otis died. That, 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 that. I was singing a sad song. And it only meant that Otis died. That, 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 that. As it stumbled toward the stage, he was looking back at me. His lips were kind of trembling as he whispered quietly. He said his favorite sang in a small twin plane. It was war in Wisconsin. He died that very day. And good riding over and Jerry's favorite song. And I was singing a sad song, baby, on the night the Otis died. Da-da-da-da-da. I was singing a sad song, baby, on the night the Otis died. Da-da-da-da-da. I'm singing a sad song on the night the Otis died.
Yeah.
Thank you.